Bit pony without the old
without the TV.
Are we going? Yeah, we are going, yeah.
Chris has won the leg.
Couldn't lose it after that fucking leg.
Fancy this to be a title game tonight.
Yeah, this has got 7-0 written all over it. Yeah.
Both quite aggressive.
Yeah. James has already offered someone out outside. He's that aggressive. Anybody that is watching, you'll have to bear with us because we haven't actually got a TV, so we're only watching it at eye level ourselves.
Yeah. That doesn't look like a bad break, and I think it's red to the balls to take here.
Can't fucking see. He's going to play the plant onto it, is he?
Ooh, it's a bit of a stinker.
Open table. And Ronnie won't be happy with that one.
I'd just like to say Adam Tinian has had an absolute shocker tonight.
Yeah, thanks, wee man.
Yeah. Fucking ferret.
Should be a straightforward run out.
Yeah.
Saying that, I kept saying that the other night and it wasn't for me. Chris has got off to a stinker. He looked that time, he acknowledged me. Yeah.
Ooh.
Still in complete control.
Yeah.
Unexpected miss by Jimmy. Jimmy Hall.
Good shot from Chris.
So he has gained control of the table with that shot, though. Who did he play to start off with?
Smithers.
So they're both looking for their second victory in the Thanet of Leet 2017. Should be, we're definitely in for a tight match here. If anything is to go by the first frame, we could be in for a bit of a tight one. Hope there's enough camera.
Looks like Chris has taken control of this frame now all of a sudden.
Yeah, he's in control.
That's a lovely pot to the
it's
middle.
A good pot. That's a well, he's obviously going for the takeout.
So very aggressive. Can't help himself.
Which one? So I think I'll be playing the other one first. Loads right hand side. Pressure's on now. The pressure was on with that shot. He had to get it right. Yeah. Whereas the other one, he was still yeah. Well, this frame's to and fro'd quite quickly.
Yeah.
And the rocket looks a little bit unsettled at the moment. Little look up to the commentary box, disapproving look. one good shot here and that's it.
He doesn't look happy though.
Does it pot into the middle? It must pot into the middle if he's playing that. It's up off of that pretty quick. Oh, he got a bit
nice
lucky
nudge.
There. Yeah, got a bit lucky there. It's a big pot. Big pot. Oh, we weren't sure. The, bent the knees.
That pocket is tight now.
Yeah, yes, yeah.
Stratton's taking the 2-0 advantage over Tinian already.
Racing into a 2-0 lead over Adam Weeman Tinian. He's not comfortable and he's not sure about this. He fancies seeing off, so he'll be digging. Will he be digging down or playing? Looks like playing
he's
ball.
Playing ball.
Oh, that was a snatch. A snatch.
Jumped up for you.
Yeah, yeah. Just
a couple of twitches in this frame. Early frame
yeah. Doesn't bode well for us and our camera knife.
No.
I will say, obviously, Chris has acknowledged that he has been watching a few matches back, so he will be listening to this as I say it to him. Could do with eating a fucking a good meal, mate. Take a leaf out of my book. Eat everything in sight. Do yourself a favour. But on the upside, he goes 1-0 up.
His wife ain't bad looking.
Really?
Yeah.
I can't really comment. Himself. He might be a fucking black belt under all that, so I better not say anything. Plus, I haven't seen her, but I mean, you're his mate.
Yeah,
so.
He's done all right for himself.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Is it one of those, what the fuck is he doing with her?
Pretty much, yeah.
Yeah, fair play. Fair play, Christopher. Well, Ronnie takes a 1-0 lead there. A little bit of a fist pump, wow. It's frowned upon in this league after last week's shenanigans.
Mr. Cross nearly getting chinned.
Yeah, and with Andy Cross fist pumping in the second round of matches. Over on table one, Kieran's taken a 1-0 lead against Finney. And all the matches this year, other than knockout stages, are first to eights. So it's a long way to go in all the matches. Red Bull's down.
Just doesn't look happy with anything at the moment.
I noticed when I was breaking, I mean, obviously I had five dry breaks, so it's easy for me to say, but I feel like the pro cuts don't break as well as what some of the other balls do.
No.
Me personally.
I just break like a cunt anyway, so.
Look like one at all.
Yeah.
I've still got my drink. Didn't realise I still had it.
Usual Milo grunt.
Wow, he looks to be rushing. It's not as he doesn't look as solid as he was last week.
Camera might be getting to him.
It does get to people. I'd just like to congratulate Kieran on his victory. As Vinny's swearing at me. So what's that? 8-0 Kieran?
Bogner. Chris going for the clearance here. I think the yellow by the black is going to cause him problems.
He tried to flick it out there, I think. Has he got the angle to do it here? Can't quite tell.
I don't think so.
See, he'd be looking to try and come over the right-hand side of the table, really, but with the red into the bottom pocket blocking it off, it's not a straightforward run out from here. He might do well in maybe trying to tie the game up a bit, but I'm not too sure of a shot there.
It's not really his style.
No, it's not mine either, but I'm just trying to humour the
viewers.
The fucking
all ten of them.
All the jiffers. All the fucking stitch artists. Yeah. basically the people that get left behind in the game because they can't pot their way out of trouble. He's had a go.
Oh, I'll tell you.
That's a good hit. He's a little bit unlucky unless that goes into the middle. Can't quite tell from the commentary box.
The red's in the way, I feel. He's got to play safe here somehow.
Could he not play off the right-hand side of that yellow onto the other yellow? Just roll it up dead weight to it?
Yeah.
What was he? I know, he's blocking. He's tried to block
that. That's a good shot. That's a very good shot. Not sure how much of it was intended, but...
Yeah. Well, he's hit it. So...
There he is. Three for a one-er. Old Craig Shield.
Shieldies.
Little roll up here.
Another little tuck up there.
Should be easy enough to get out of one cushion. Yeah.
There's eight. Skip.
Apologies for this music. It's toilet.
It is about to be muted. What's obviously Chris is your pal.
Hmm.
Not that James isn't, but obviously you spend a lot more time with Chris than you do James. What do you predict the score for tonight? Wow, he's not happy with it. He's
no. I'm gonna go. It's tricky.
You're gonna back your mate or?
It's tricky because James beat Stratton last week.
Yeah, and James has actually beaten Andy before.
And he beat Smoothers in the knockouts.
Yeah, I mean, the thing is, he doesn't look very solid at the moment, but he's capable of bringing his game together. But then, I mean, I haven't seen a lot of Chris, but I'm taking it he is as well.
Chris is one of them. He can literally just go on a mad run and pot everything on the table.
Yeah.
I'm going to go 8-6, Chris.
You're going 8-6, Chris? I'm going to go, I think I'm going to go for 8-5. Jimmy. I think he'll probably pull it together. Yeah. He's a good player, Jimmy.
Oh, yeah.
But Chris looks a little bit unsettled. That's the only reason I say that.
To be fair, they both look a bit unsettled to begin with.
Yeah. But at the moment, James is in complete control of this frame. All he wants to do is not leave himself an angle or give away two shots.
Would you reckon cut the yellow back and go into the others?
For me?
Yeah.
Yes. But...
I think I'd be going that way. He tried to, but he threw a bit of a winger. He hit the yellow.
I think it did hit, yeah. Yeah, Chris is known for his cheating, so... Yeah, no. Yeah, no. I think he skimmed it.
Could be a long frame for Chris now.
I'll just take a quick phone call.
Who is this calling, Johnny Boy? I think that's a foul. He hasn't. Bit unlucky there. Should be straightforward from here. Take the red over the pocket. Got a nice flick there, but still doesn't look happy with himself. Bit of a bad shot from James.
Left himself a little bit of an awkward shot here, isn't he?
Yeah, he's he had two shots, quite a simple clearance, and just don't know, it's early doors, and it hasn't really got going yet. But that's a good shot.
It is if he hasn't blocked it.
This place is getting worse. It's just Toby after Toby that comes in.
Plenty of them about. See, the. When it's at this sort of level, playing in front of a camera, it does get to you.
Yeah.
Well,
he's made a lot of hard work.
May be changing my prediction, but no, I'm gonna stick with it. But he's not in tune, is he?
He's made very hard work this.
Great double! That is a great double. What a shot that is.
It's a good recovery.
In the context of this match, that is massive.
Vinny keeps looking over at the commentary box.
Got it. What happened there?
No, we wasn't.
I'm assuming you got lucky. Well, 1-0. I'm not changing my prediction.
Oh, Andy just sticking his fucking nose in it. Fuck off, Andy.
Yeah. As one of the runners of the tournament, surely you might have fucking said that to start off with, you Toby. Surely you might have said that to start off with.
You couldn't even ref last week, you cunt. Your refing last week was awful.
We can't see. The TV's not working.
Paul in after abusing Andy for a little bit.
Fuck him, cunt.
He brought one of his birds down tonight.
Nice of him, yeah. The worst one.
You haven't seen the other one?
No, I'm joking. It's always good for a nosh, apparently. Wow. Fucking what is going on, man?
Both players don't look settled at all.
Maybe it's the fact that people are obviously calling their shots. But what's the score?
Stratton is framing up, yeah. Kieran's 2-1.
Racing away with it. That is not that bad. Plays it into the top left hand corner as we see it, back towards the camera.
Play it off the
dead weight. I'm almost playing it dead weight to leave it in a jaw if I miss it.
When you play it off the yellow though, so the other way it goes.
I think it's too far away from the pocket, isn't it? No, it wasn't there. From where I was sitting, it looked too. Just shows you without the TV, you're fucked. Wow, that was a kick. That was a kick. That was.
It's not bad though.
That was a heavy contact. It was definitely a heavy contact. But yeah, as you say, if you're gonna miss like that. Well, Chris is in complete control of this frame at the moment, but we said that in the last frame, and
yeah, they all changed.
That's to and fro. Yeah. Not bad. Thirsty work, this commentary malarkey.
It's that kebab we had earlier.
Fell on deaf ears, that one.
Darren's got cashbot. What a cunt. That's 400 quid.
Oh, that makes me feel sick.
At least it weren't ice.
Yeah, that's true. Sorry, Nepal. We got distracted from Nepal.
The worst thing is, you was playing it.
I was playing the other one.
No, he's playing the other. Oh, that is sick.
Yeah.
That is sick.
Oh, mate. Was he playing it on 25p as well?
I'm not sure, but he got asked no, so that is the only way that they can possibly get it.
Oh,
for
mate.
Them, anyway. The way I was going to play it next week if I had any dough, but obviously not.
You better get the beers in, the little
yeah,
bitch.
Yeah, yeah, be getting them in. Yeah, mine's a jug of Foster's. Free for a water.
Free for a water, let's go.
Right, anyway, back at the ranch. 4-0 Stratton.
So oh, that's missed. Oh, that's missed.
Still in control, Chris. Not, he don't seem settled himself yet.
Nah, neither player does, really. I'm very tilted that Darren's won 400 quid.
Well, you know. Might try and tap him. Million.
Why did he need you for it?
Because he didn't know how to collect it.
Ah.
I should have just walked over and collected the 6 quid. I'd have gone, no, you haven't got that.
Yeah.
Yeah, but the winner doesn't have Sarah's food bill.
Wow. Wow, that was a bit of a low blow from John Miles there.
I couldn't believe I just said that. Yeah. Whoopsie.
Whoopsies.
Joe told me to say it.
We should really concentrate on the match.
Yeah, I'm shouting across the match, to be fair.
These are not always easy, with it being this deep in the pocket.
He's screwing it back a few inches here.
Just left himself a shot at it.
It's a little bit twitchy, this one. Mm. This is definitely missable.
Across the table, drop in the middle.
I would say across the net, but there isn't one.
No.
What are you doing? Are you dropping this in dead weight, or are you playing it reasonable?
No, I'm thinking dropping it in dead weight.
Yeah, give it every chance of going in. Yeah, me too. Oh, no, he's gone.
Well, he's played the... He's don't know what he's played there.
Well, your is guess is as good as ours. I'm sure Chris will find out what he played next week.
Answers on a postcard. It's funny, isn't it?
That one is a total.
It's funny how he was in complete control and now he's James in complete control. Every frame's
both frames. All three frames, in fact. This one included. This one included is swung to and fro. They've both been up and down more times than a horse draws. What do you reckon? We'll be looking right down this shot for a wing. He's got two shots, hasn't he?
Yeah, so I don't know why he's playing this one.
Oh, right.
Truck deal going on here.
Well, that's a one frame penalty for being on your phone, asking his missus what shot to play.
He's playing the wrong ball here, I feel.
Yeah, I mean, why is he doing that?
With two.
He's now just going to roll up against him. Yeah. But the thing is, if he hits with two,
you roll that other yellow down to the pocket.
Oh, of course you do. Yeah. You roll it down to the pocket, you put the other one, the frame's over. But now he's going to roll this up. And as if Chris hits this, he's in the soup.
Because if Chris can land behind it as well and get a snooker back, possibly.
Yep. Yep. He's definitely the shot. He's played it a bit hard.
Too hard, but he's pied it.
Ooh, see, look.
Now look at the pressure.
Soup. Massively in the soup. I mean, this is just another example of the frames going to and fro.
This is a massive pressure pop.
I fancy him to rattle this. I'm not sure if it's the camera or, you know, maybe he's got other things on his mind, but he's not thinking really he's not thinking clearly at all. I mean, for me, that is just a roll the ball down the cushion.
I mean, by the sounds of the thing, his crack's being delivered to his house now, so.
Well.
Darren getting the beers in?
He fucking wants to be. Might get him to get me a jug.
Nah, stop it.
I could murder a pint, to be fair.
Yeah.
Absolutely hanging out for a beer. Vinny's pulled it back to 3-2. Adam's got his first frame on the board at 4-1 now.
Oh, and that's an open table.
That is an open table.
Chris, if Chris can take this out in one visit.
It's going to put the pressure on, isn't it?
Yeah. Go 3-1 up and all of a sudden.
Even at 3-1, you can start to see the finish line a little bit. And the other player thinks, oh.
I did it against Mr. Mason until he got a kick that helped.
Yeah. Not.
Oh,
wow.
That's a bad miss.
Didn't expect that.
It's a bad miss.
Well, they both don't look in complete control of their own games at the moment. I've seen them both play better than that.
Like you said, it might just be the TV table.
Does do it to the best of us. From time to time. That small little lens can mean so much within your head.
Mm-hmm.
It also takes quite a lot of height off of people. I would like to say that Jimmy is actually 7'3". I know he looks about 4 foot wet, but he is. Actually, I shouldn't be out of order because he's probably at least 5 foot now, isn't he?
Yeah, I mean, he.
Good part. That's opening it right up.
He's no longer considered a dwarf.
That could be a frame winner, that.
Yeah.
And.
Boost his confidence massively.
Just one little shot. I mean, that's not the greatest shot he's ever played if he's straight on it. But one little shot can and one run out can change everything. Depends what sort of angle he's got on it. He's rolling it in, so.
That's another bad miss. Both of them are doing
yeah,
it.
Yeah, yeah. Anything other than straight there, and he would have been able to roll it through nicely.
I don't think this red goes up the top. I think there's a yellow in the way.
Must have went. Snuck past it. Good shot. If he can manage to screw this back and play it into the same, into the middle, left-hand middle pocket.
Yeah, just screw it back a couple of inches.
We could be on for 3-1. Looks like he's topping it through. Well, I'm not sure about that. He's putting a lot of pressure on this positional shot, though.
Yeah.
There's a lot of pressure on this.
You've got to try and find the gap or go around the back.
To be honest, I'm going past the yellow.
Yeah.
Because if you over here, you're on the one into the top pocket. He's missed it anyway.
It was very rushed. Very rushed.
Well,
and you saw the frustration in his face there.
Yeah, big show of emotion there, banging his cue. Well, if Jimmy's got any aspirations of winning this match, he's got to take this out.
Yeah. Lizzie!
Skip. He can't even see. Skip the tune.
The
Vin, have you watched your match back yet?
He's played another poor shot there.
Well, he's putting a lot of pressure on these last balls all the time.
Yeah, I bet he has.
Oh, it's
a good pot, but now he's got a tough black still.
Yeah, this is a tough pot. At 2-1 down, this is a tough pot. This is the difference between all level and two behind.
Looks like he's nailed it.
No, ooh. Not even in the jaws, that one.
From not where even I'm in sitting, the jaws. It looked like he nailed it.
Really?
It helped that he was in the way.
Yeah. Well, this is at the moment. This is a bit of a calamity of errors.
Yeah.
I mean, under the circumstances, the way this match has gone so far, you wouldn't necessarily say that Chris is going to take this out here.
No.
It's not a certainty.
Got to be playing the one in the middle first, surely.
I mean,
because then it's just a case of rolling balls in.
Oh, he's taking the other route.
Yeah.
But that is a total, so if Jimmy can find a way to block. To block it off, then he's in trouble. He's hit it.
Yeah.
Well, if this isn't 3-1, we might as well lock up and go home. Just got to watch the in off into the middle here. No, he's played it well. Yeah, he's played it twice, across to take that out of play.
Oh, he doesn't want that on the cushion, though. No.
As long as it's not dead straight. If it is dead straight, oh, it's getting straight down, so it must have a reasonable angle. The only thing that can go wrong is if it spots it.
Oh, wow. Oh, and he's gone in off.
Wow.
Jug of Foster's for me, mate, please.
Yeah, cheers. Shut up.
Oh, you got me a jug?
Yeah,
a
jug for you and Carl.
Oh, cheers, mate.
Wow. Foster's and lime, please, mate. Thank you.
Fucking way. Go on, Dazza. Just like to congratulate Dazza on winning the cash pot of £400 on the fruity. At least it went to someone that we know rather than some other tobe. I mean, obviously, in hindsight, we'd all prefer it to be us. I mean, that goes without saying, but...
And he's mincing about being a dick as usual.
With his schneid England top on. That fucking shirt's a problem.
It's a bit tight, mate. No, you fucking ain't.
Smuggling raisins, mate.
Yeah.
Right, we're going to go and write some scores down last week.
Alright.
Why don't you fuck off? Would you like to take over for a second while I smoke?
We're both. This match is a calamity of errors at the moment.
Is it?
They're both struggling big time.
Right, okay.
It is 2-2, and I'm not joking, every single one of the frames could have gone. I have two and throwed about four or five times in each frame.
Right. What's
they're both much more capable than how they're playing at the moment, but sometimes it is the pressure of that big lens. Does it to you?
Yeah,
it can do it to you.
It can do if you're noticing it. I mean, you've just got to completely forget
about
it.
If you play under the cameras quite a lot, then it doesn't make any difference. But if you're only once, you know, you're there
twice,
every now
once,
and then.
Twice a season, it's different, isn't
oh,
it?
Oh, yeah, of course, yeah.
You know. I mean, before this game started, I thought James was like favourite. Sort of 8-5, 8-6 sort of thing.
That's exactly what I said, 8-5. Joe's gone for 8-6 the other way.
Has he? Yeah, well, Chris is his friend, so, you know, that's fair play for Joe.
They're both not in control of their own games at the moment, especially Chris. I mean, he's slammed his cue down. Was he? Yeah, he's... I think it's getting to him how bad he's playing at the moment. I've definitely seen him play better myself. I haven't seen much of him, but I know he can play better than how he is at the moment.
Well, at the end of the day, I suppose, he may be slamming his cue, but he's still in the match. 2-2s. It's banging in at any. So.
Yeah, it's not over at Desmond. Definitely not. He's overdone that. He might still have the angle to take the one into the middle, but I can't quite see where the next shot's coming after that. for me, a good safety will is the order of the day. Yeah,
yeah, and just break open all
these
reds.
I think he's taking this on into the top. Oh wow!
Yeah, I see what you were saying from earlier. Yeah. I think your word sort of summed it up: calamity of errors.
Yeah, I mean, so this is slowly but surely falling further out of position. Where, as I say, they're both more than capable of running off three or four frames
what's
on the trot without
do? Knock red onto yellow, knock it out.
Yep.
And clear up, pretty much.
Yeah, I mean, but how it's gone recently in the first four frames, this is nowhere near over this frame.
Right. Okay.
It should be.
You're expecting them both to have a couple more chances each, sort of thing. Is that what you're suggesting?
Yeah, I mean, there was a black and two colours on the table, and they both had two visits each.
Yeah, I did actually see that frame, so yeah, I understand.
But, I mean, even that shot there, he's under hit it. It only just went into the pocket. He is definitely more than capable. That's a good shot.
Yeah, that's a good shot. Yeah.
More than capable of taking this out. But it's being in control.
Just last time I spoke to Joe, he said Chris is like improving all the time. He's an improving player. You know?
Yeah, yeah, 100%. So yeah, that's I've heard the same from Joe myself.
I think week one wasn't he on the camera, Chris? Didn't
I'm
the two new
sure.
boys, or was it not him? It was the other one.
It was Vinny and Kenny.
Right.
Cheers, Dazza. Well done, boy.
Well done, mate. Well done.
That'll buy a few nappies, won't it?
Yeah. Extra turbo for the little chip, more of a chip on the car, yeah. Or
Sarah, make sure he treats our child with that money.
Oh, it's him. Yep.
Should get this in. Yep. Straightforward now.
After saying this isn't a straightforward run out, he's actually taking it out well.
You do find with some people's pump, it will try to do too much on a simple shot, really. Like, do that. Just don't screw it back a couple of inches. It's just
you could even run it through. There's no need to really do any more than needs to be. But that, at the end of the day, 3-2, and he has managed to take it out. So
he has, so there was no two shots each there, was there?
No. Maybe he's
this
starting
is
to pick up
where we're
the
stepping
pace.
It up now, yeah. Hopefully they'll both start stepping it up, and it'll be a good match.
Yep, that is actually James standing up. Oh no, look, he's on stilts, Wes.
You wait till you listen to this back, James. Yeah, I bet. Full commentary, mate.
The catchphrase, a calamity of errors, has occurred about seven times so far. No, you're both not playing to how you normally play, innit? No, I've seen you play much better than this. Just enjoy it, innit? That's what it's about. It won't be won or lost in one game, so. Oh, yeah, yeah. I've got to sit next to this cunt. He beat me last week.
But the cunt in question is Mr. Andy Quass, obviously, four-time champion. So we've officially got a VIP in the box. Oh, I'd just like to say, Andy, I take this opportunity to tell you that I made a 1-2-4 yesterday.
Did you?
Yeah, out of blue. Yeah, I was playing like a cunt, come out of nowhere. Always nice.
1-2-4 is lovely.
Lovely, bro.
Yeah, it is.
A couple of exhibition shots in there.
Have you not been getting anywhere near centuries in before?
No.
Nothing.
Well, I've made hundreds of centuries.
Yeah,
it's like,
but you haven't been.
Eighties and that regularly, but eighties were more of an occurrence.
Popping up, yeah.
Yeah, because I tend to, when I get over the winning line, try to play ridiculous shots.
Exhibition.
Yeah, because it doesn't matter. I'm not bothered about making hundreds, but it's always nice to make a bigger.
Of course it is.
I was on a max earlier as well, but I didn't realise I had 10 reds, 10 blacks.
Right, okay.
10 reds.
Yeah.
And I screwed down for a pink, and then Joe went, are you not
why
taking
are you doing
a black?
This? Yeah.
And then I went, why? And he was like, you're on a max.
I went, oh shit.
Yeah.
That was a bit of a mistake, really, wasn't it?
Yeah, yeah.
All right, okay.
Because I had to play the pink to go into the reds. But,
bit silly, but...
Never mind. I've been there before, 12 reds, 12 blacks.
Have you? And then got a bit twitchy,
No, I got massive kick.
Oh. Was it on that table?
No, it wasn't in this table. That was on table one at Northdown, that was.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Was that the one that Huey used to play
on? Yeah,
that table.
Yeah, when
thing?
It was all... when the pockets were cut as well.
Is it not as cut
now?
No,
they're not now, no. But they were cut tighter than a professional table.
Yeah.
It was a fucking nightmare.
well done for the 1-2-4 anyway. It does make you feel good, doesn't it, when you get a slip at 1-2-4 in?
Yeah, yeah, it was nice.
It is nice.
But only wins one frame at the end.
Was that a total clearance or was that a...
Might have been.
From...
I'm not sure.
Early doors sort of in the frame and just cleared up?
I think it was pretty much everything.
That's what you want, isn't it? It's nice.
Not sure if James has been on the sunbeds, but he's got a very red face.
No, he's too busy working, I believe.
Shirking, are you?
I think he's got new trainers on.
They do look new to be fair.
Are they matching his top? Maybe, sort of white.
Maybe he's spending his elite money that he feels he's going to win.
Yes. Yeah. Yes, he's spending his last 16 minimum winnings already.
Hopefully, with any luck, he'll buy you a nose hair trimmer. Because they are worse than mine, mate.
Are they?
Yeah, fucking hell, mate. It's like them. You've got a ton of spiders up there, haven't you?
Yeah, they are. They're dangling out. Cheeking of it, Vinny, eh? To be fair, I have got a nose trimmer. I just don't use it.
Or is it broken?
It is broken. It is broken.
Yeah, it's fucking overworked with those things, mate.
Yeah, it is.
Like trying to cut a tree down with a pair of scissors.
You need a lawnmower, don't you? You need a lawnmower up there. But yeah, I do agree with you.
Like trying to cut a pair of... a fucking tree down with a pair of scissors.
I do, you just... like, you can feel them, can't you? It's like, you go like, oh, what?
I don't get a chance. If my missus sees them, mate, she'll fucking yank them straight out.
Will she? Yeah, mate. Just straight out clean, yeah?
Yeah, oh, mate. Yeah, she makes me cry.
Does she?
Yeah. For other reasons.
Yeah, that's not the only reason, yeah.
Fucking not everybody likes a digit.
Back to the pool.
That's a bit unlucky. Sarah's back in the gaff, look. Loves a mosh, apparently.
What's she doing now? I can't see her. Where is she?
I don't know. She's on her knees.
Is she?
I don't think she's Muslim. I think she's not praying.
I think she's probably trying to get some cash out of Darren. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. A little bit of a lap dance.
Yeah, yeah. Hopefully he's got an extra strong lap. Yeah.
An extra strong lap.
What are you suggesting there, John?
Well, I mean, she's fucking hell. Who's cackling? Is that your missus?
Yeah, yeah. It's cackle those.
I'd just like to say that Andy, after saying he wasn't going to bring her anymore, has now brought his missus down again.
I didn't bring her down. Can I point that out? She said when I took her, I'm coming down. Well, I should have put my foot down, you're saying, and said, no, fuck off?
Yeah. I mean, this is a man-only club.
Well, Sarah's that. Oh, yeah, Sarah's more of a...
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Otherwise, we can't let Darren in, can't we?
I'll just make this in my last frame. I'm going to hand back over to Joe. Apparently not. I'm not going to be handing Matt, just yet.
Yeah, yeah. Joe's touching cloth, so.
Yeah.
Anyway, we won't talk
about
it.
Today, did you, Joe?
Yeah. Oh, mate.
What was it? One. Mixed or? Mixed, like.
When you haven't eaten all day and then you just want the worst possible meal ever, which is what we had. And I had...
Well, this is interesting.
A large... Fuck the pool. Okay, I'm talking about my food.
Okay. All right, carry on.
I had a large mixed doner with chilli and garlic sauce, onions and lettuce. So I smell like a fucking back end of Sarah. And I had some chips with garlic sauce as well. And I ate the fucking lot even though I was full halfway through because I'm a fat pig and that's what happens. And plus, I didn't have to pay for it.
Why you didn't have to pay for it?
No. It was on the free roll from Joey C.
Was it?
Yeah, it was nice.
Well, that was nice. That was nice.
Yeah, it was a turn up for the books.
What did you go for, Joe?
I had a large doner.
Large doner, yeah.
Pretty much the same.
All right.
Oh, no. Yeah, yeah. Burger and chilli sauce.
I did like the look of yours the other week, actually.
That was Tinian. Yeah, yeah, he's the one that done it.
Yeah.
Is
yeah, it was really good.
Shot,
it looked a really nice colour of sauce.
Chris mugged himself by getting up. Look.
So we've got this. The game on table one is very tight.
Yeah, yeah.
Can't call that one. Vinny versus Kieran. 4-4.
Just like to
Quick all shout to play out to for. Carl, currently winning this match 6-1. Adam probably will be listening to this just to make sure there's anything about him in it, which I'm not going to mention him. He's 6-1 down. He was my shout to do damage this year. Fucking egg.
Can I ask you then about the later games? Craig Smethers, Joe Cunningham.
Yep.
What are you feeling there? What's your thoughts?
That's a good shot. Is 3-3 very quickly?
Is we're going to get Joe turning up tonight? And
I'd like
dominating
to see
the
Joe
game.
Win. I would like to. I mean, Joe's my pal, obviously.
Yeah.
I would prefer Joe to win. I should.
Joe's,
I am meant to
Joe's
stay.
Joe's my pal
to
too. So
you haven't got friends, Andy. We've
okay.
been through this.
All right. Right. Okay. We
are your acquaintance.
Both of them are my friends, really. Craig, obviously, I've known him for years.
Fuck Craig. No.
No, I would. You can if you want. Fuck him. But I think it should be close.
Oh yeah, it'd definitely be close. It's just if Joe can go a couple in front, then obviously Craig will start screaming. It'll get. To
yeah, him. We'll see who smashes the table first.
Well, it won't
be Joe.
No, it won't be Joe. The best thing you can do against Smithers is to keep your own game or your own head. Even if you're not playing very well, if you keep your own head, you stand a chance against him.
Yeah.
He was 4-1 up on Adam last week and he lost his head over one frame.
Yeah.
And Adam, it was 5-1 up and he got it back. And Adam got it back to 5-4.
I'm going to be quite sad here and say over the last few days, I actually have rewatched your game versus Craig Smethers twice on YouTube. And I wanted to ask you the question because you can't tell what the score is. What you smashed him up.
I kept seeing you winning frames.
What was the score?
He's still yet to beat me in any form of pool.
Who, Craig?
Yes.
See, he's another one of those, let's not going to throw it out there, nearly men, that nearly win stuff but doesn't. Am I right in, is that a fair point?
Well, he's nearly won this twice, has he?
Yeah, he's been in the final twice.
So he's nearly won it twice.
Yeah, but he's been close in other things as well.
Like what? He almost got a manager's job up the Toby.
I don't know, did he?
Up the Schneid Toby.
Up the old Tobe.
I don't know.
It'd be interesting tonight, you know? Who's going
to
stamp their authority?
The match will
Who's going to stamp their authority on that match?
I'm going for Joe 8-5. Because even, I mean, no matter what happens, a player of Craig's class, a player of Joe's class, they're going to take 5 off each other no matter how they're playing. I really should have taken 5 off of you, but I don't think it would have mattered. You was playing the way you played, and I was always going to lose that match. So even, I mean, in the top games, they're hardly ever...
They're close.
8-2s,
it should be
are they, or 8-1s. There's none of that happening.
Well, it can be with a break and that. You know, you see it last... You saw it with Colfer and Sean last semi... What was it? In the quarterfinals last year, he got smashed up 8-1. With the breaks. And
yeah,
the
I mean, yeah. Arsenal lost 8-2 at United once, but it doesn't happen every season.
It does, yeah. It did do that, yeah.
It doesn't happen every season.
I'm struggling to call it, to be honest. I think it's going to go close. That's really sitting on the fence, I know.
So
you've gone Joe 8-5, I'm going to go Craig 8-7.
You don't have to oppose me. You can go with the same one if you wish.
Can I?
Yeah, if you wanted to.
No,
but
I'm going to try
but
it out. I want Joe to step up, basically. I want Joe to step up tonight.
Yeah, yeah.
He's a bit one of those.
Well,
I'll be honest and say that Joe seems to come unstuck against the bigger players more than not. I want to be proved wrong, and I want him to step up tonight. I would be more than happy to see him win if he wins.
I mean,
I'm quite.
To see
him
I'm quite
confident. And play well.
Yes, two. Yeah, that's good sportsmanship by Chris. He called a foul on himself.
Yeah, if he wouldn't, I don't blame him for not. You know, let's all.
Yeah, oh, imaginary white ball.
It's the right
he
thing
He hasn't realised that the cue ball's actually in front of him. He's trying to play the ball that isn't there. Yeah. Oh, Chris using my lines.
I think he's 5-4 up in
5-4.
Wow,
he's done well to turn that around. He was 3-1 down in that match. So
Carl is one frame from ending. And we've got table three. Well, Sal and Sean will be nearly 7-1 already. Carl only wants one frame.
Yeah, he wants one more frame for victory.
To be fair, Adam's been quite disappointing tonight.
Yeah, well, he had a Margay match earlier, and he played quite well.
What was it? Is it
Chris.
He finished 6-0?
It was 6-0, yeah.
It was 6-0.
This looks like a... I don't know if that black passes. I'm not too sure. I mean, I'm assuming it does. He's coming around to have a look at it.
Yeah,
now.
I imagine he fiddles his games in his league because he runs it. So he probably...
Imagine he fiddles stuff. But this looks like going 4-3. I mean, Jimmy's come around to have a look at this. He did look at it, this shot before last, which I think he should have looked at it a little bit earlier.
Yeah.
But in it goes.
4-3. To James.
Well... I will say,
there's only the two games then on tonight. There's only the
because Kenny is
playing.
He'll be playing with John because Kenny is currently on his honeymoon.
Very nice.
Yep. No one knows where he's gone. Not even his pal.
Not even his partner.
No.
It'd be a tricky one, wouldn't it?
Probably gone to Bognor on a fucking button this weekend.
Yeah, on the old £9.50 sun weekend.
Yeah, why not?
Yeah.
Well.
There's Cackle.
This league will become more and more competitive every year, I believe.
Just want to build the standard up, really. We have got rid of some of the
shit players
and the aggro players.
It doesn't matter how good you are. We don't have any divas in this league.
You know, no matter how good James Addison was, we had to get rid of him.
Yep. Yeah, he's more than capable player, but he's his own worst enemy.
Yeah,
so
he is. Yeah,
he's gone. There'll be people. More players that want to come into it. It's being run how it should be run. And the most important thing out of everything is that all the, shall we say, runners of the competition are able to brush their teeth.
I think three big things have come out of Thanet Elite this year, and that's getting rid of the aggro and not-so-good players, the website, and having a decent camera up. And possibly commentary week on week.
Yep,
I think that's their massive improvements.
And obviously the format has changed. And people seem to be a lot more happy with the format. And it's less pressure. And there's on the emphasis. Doesn't matter. If you lose 8-1.
It's done.
Whatever. It's next week. You've got... You can turn it around.
Exactly.
If the person you beat lost to 8-1 loses, then it's pretty much a level game.
Exactly, yeah. Yeah. Who have you got next week then, John? Do you know?
I just want to refer over to Vinny there. It's
back over to table one, yeah?
Yeah, it's about to go 6-4 up, and he fluked the red there. Oh, wow, there's a little bit of tension in that. Oh, no, surely not.
You have got. Rolled a little bit, yeah?
Right, so say that.
You got next week?
I don't know.
Tricky game?
Not sure.
Oh, okay.
I'm not sure who I've got next week.
I thought you might have had a decent game, half-decent game, actually.
Might do. Have to have a little Luke.
I know I've got Sean Kirby.
Who you
should
have?
Should be lively.
Yeah, that'd be a good game. That'll be on that'll be on the TV table.
I'll have a look. Let's go on to the Thanet Elite.
It's like the same as the Sean... The best dressed man in Thanet
has just walked in.
Best dressed man in Thanet's walked in, and he lives up to his reputation.
He has lived up to it. He looks sharp, doesn't he?
He always looks sharp.
He always like steps his game up, doesn't he? Right, okay. You've got Lucas.
I've got Lucas next week.
And
wow.
I've got Sean. Two easy games.
Easy victory for me then.
Yep.
Lucas, I'll avenge my
defeat in the quarters. Yeah.
Blew myself up. Never mind.
Yeah.
He played well though, to be fair.
That'll be interesting to see who's going to go on this table again, if not both those games.
Well, we'll have to have one at one time and one at another, more than likely.
You're thinking. And then the fortnight after, you've got Ian Garrett. So,
yeah, gay rap.
Yeah, and I've got Lucas.
The group that we're in is a very strong group. Not that the other one isn't, but there's always going to be a stronger group.
Yeah.
More than often, anyway, and I believe it to be Group B. But back at the ranch, very quickly, we've been looking away from it, and it looks like James could be going 5-3 up here.
That looks a decent burger, doesn't it, John? Decent burger.
Where's that then?
I don't know. Mick Lynch just sent that to me.
Yeah, send that back. So guess whose hand that is?
Hey. Oh, you want me to take a camera of that? You want me to take a photo of that, do you? Don't show your car. I'll see your face. Oh, I've never taken a... That's the first time. Oh, yeah, that's all right.
Hold on a minute.
That's all right, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, send that back then.
Well, it looked like it was going to go 5-3. Looked like it was going to go 5-3, but Chris is now in complete control of this frame, and you'd expect it from here to go 4-all, wouldn't you, Andy? Who's James being yellows. I know you've looked away, but James is yellows. He missed the pot into the middle.
That was a big one. You were saying about for 5-3 there, weren't you? So
yeah, yeah. He should have got the pot, to be fair.
Any class... half decent player here should be winning this frame.
The what's his name?
The who? What are you talking about?
One of the top ball players in the world.
Mick Hill or Darren?
I think it is Mick Hill. Oh. He always says, if there is one ball, if your opponent only has one ball left on the table and you've got more than three balls, you should never lose the frame.
Yeah, of course. It's all about clearing the balls, clearing up, setting yourself up. People do get out of snookers and get flukes, but...
Yeah. I mean, obviously, you can't trust to a bit of luck, and I think that's it by Stratton.
That's it. Cole match Stratton, over 8-1. Well done, 8-1.
Wow. Thanks for turning up, Adam.
Yeah. It's that's handy.
Oh, yeah, thank you.
He's going to go and get the cable.
Yeah.
Joe, are you ready to take over the rest of this, or...? Yeah? Well, you know, I'm happy to let you take back over. I'm just gearing myself up for this 9 o'clock match. Very
well,
big game.
Let's hope we've got enough battery for that.
I'm hoping it's going to be the match of all matches.
Yeah.
I don't think it'll live up to last week, but, you know, performance.
Joe does look like he's put on a slight bit of weight.
Yeah, is that what? Half a stone, is that?
Well, maybe a bit more. Well, that little nudge is going to help, is it?
No, it's not. He goes, I think. Cuts in the corner. Is that cut in the right-hand corner?
It does. Big shot, this.
Because it's in off as well, so he's got to screw it in as well, so it's tricky. That's definitely in off. That looks in off from Wyler. He can't play this with normal. He's got to screw this in. He could screw back in the same pocket. No. That was terrible.
It wasn't easy.
It wasn't easy, but it's a shot to win the frame.
Yeah.
When you're playing at the top level, they're the sort of half chances you need to take.
Sean Mason joins us in the commentary box.
Us. Welcome. How you doing, Sean? You all right?
Too bad, mate. Thank you. You?
Yeah.
You going to be skipping practice?
Have you? Make sure. Good.
A few of them little skips in.
They're very important, especially if it makes balls from the break. You know?
I can fucking buy a ball off the break.
The problem with John skipping, he's too heavy to do skipping. Sorry. He struggles with that, so...
Yeah, you know what I can do, though? Boxing, mate, so you better shut up.
He has
under-hit it, but he's still got a shot. Yeah. If he keeps his head, he's... This is 4-3 at the moment to James.
Can he roll it in off two, Rouse? Yeah, or has he got to screw it?
I think this...
Roll it in off two?
I'm not sure if he can play it plain ball or not. From the angle that I've got, it looks like he can play it plain ball, but I don't know if he can or not. But it looks like so he's doing it. He's playing the other one first. I don't disagree with that shot because he's always going to leave it over the hole more likely 9 times out of 10.
Well,
for that one, I mean, that was a lower risk pot. Yeah, but it's a lower risk pot, isn't it?
Yeah. He should have played the other one, though, shouldn't he, really?
Well, yeah, as I say, but as this match has gone on, the quality has got a little bit better, but they're not playing anywhere near where their potential is. And that just shows it there. For James to miss that, he's got to come off of one cushion. That's a bad miss.
Yeah, it wasn't great. Which table is Sean on tonight?
Sean is on table 3, which is next to the bar, against Sal the Bomber Ahmed.
Sal the Bomber Ahmed.
Paul.
Right.
You know, let's say what everybody else thinks.
He's going to think he's going to blast you off the table. His point is, he's going to blast you off the table.
I'm just addressing the elephant in the room. We're all a bit twitchy. But, you know, all jokes aside, he's a nice fella. And he takes it all in good spirit, as he should do.
Yeah, it was a good little banter between you, a little bit on there, on the chat, wasn't it?
Yeah, this is going to be for all. Back at the ranch, Chris. Chris might get a bit of confidence out of this. Oh, where's that cue ball going?
He's had a nice result there.
There's a well-played positional shot there. Lizzie doesn't give a fuck that someone's playing the shot. Just walks around him. Wow.
This is where you were saying about chances.
Yeah.
This is a big shot, this.
Jimmy. You got a
yellow. Right. Okay. Can we replace that ball, that black, or?
It's over.
That's a joke.
Well, I'd like to say Chris is devastated, but that'd be a load of bollocks.
I don't actually understand.
Well,
why.
Jimmy looks like he's had a sunbed on his way over to the scoreboard because he's gone fucking scarlet.
Did he realise that his last shot that he came across the table to try and get a snooker to hit a yellow?
Oh, I can't remember. I mean, the chances are, to be fair, he probably wasn't going to pot that anyway.
I think
but
he just got so excited he missed it, didn't he?
It's starting to cushion. Obviously, you're playing it. I'm playing that shot with extreme right hand side to try and wing it across to the bottom cushion.
I really
bottom rail.
Studied that long. I mean, that looked the obvious shot because otherwise you're flapping it around the table.
Yeah,
aren't you?
I think it was tight to the cushion. So, I mean, the chance side wasn't going to pie it anyway, but potting the black is obviously helping out.
He's obviously didn't fancy it, did he? He didn't fancy the yellow and thought no. Yes.
I'm blowing it that way. I've had a mixed kebab.
Dirty kebab.
Sauce and fucking chili sauce. I blew it that way out of fucking respect for everybody in the commentary box.
Thank you, John.
Well,
thank you, John.
For all.
An interesting way to get the for all, wasn't
it? Yeah, yeah.
But, you know. Well,
James is obviously trying to fuck up my score prediction.
This is obviously looking.
I can't tell you that.
One good shot here, John. And
let's put this way. I didn't say 8-3 anyone, so you're all right. You're both safe.
No disrespect, Johnny, but he should be taking his out for 5-4.
Yeah.
Just rolled us in.
Yeah. Saying that, I mean, I said that about 100 times last week. And then I played.
No, he's all right.
I played my match and fucking missed everything. Well, missed my chances.
You missed your chances, yeah. Absolutely.
But you just missed the question of sport moment.
Question of sport moment. You missed there, mate. Yeah.
Chris had a pot into the top left-hand bag. Yeah.
And James had a yellow on the bottom rail.
Didn't realise and just spotted the black. Because he's a wally.
Shot of the night.
There's no action replay. Sorry, mate. That'll be on question of sport, that will.
Just got to play this with extreme check side.
Yeah,
just
I'll be checking
back up.
Yeah, 100%. It's a pretty straightforward shot, to be fair. Oh, it's going the other way. And he's not on it. And as you say, this is pretty much how the match has gone, to and fro like that. Mm. If one player could get control of the cue ball, then I think that would win the match there and then. It's not very good. No, because it's hard to tell what it is. You actually need that angle.
I'm going to show you
how
to get the cables now.
I'd leave if I lost 8-1 as well. You're meant to be my surprise package.
Yes.
You got fucked.
I got fucking done. I don't even know.
He gave you the surprise package, did he?
But considering I played Chris and had a good game.
I know. I was expecting
you did.
To
six
be
each, wasn't it?
I don't even know what to
six
say.
Six apiece.
Shockingly bad.
Can I ask when my video's going up from last week?
Have you lost it?
Right.
Oh, shit. I may have deleted it.
Because I texted him about it.
I missed one ball in the whole match and you deleted that. No, I know you haven't. I know you're right about
it. I might fucking delete it.
Don't let him anywhere near it. Just get it up on YouTube,
it'll
all right?
At the same time this one's up that you were talking
about. Oh, right, okay. I've been going... I've
We've
been
made
YouTubing
no references to your
it.
Size or anything. No.
To the site?
No, towards your size.
Size?
Yes.
What are you saying about my belly?
I'm not about your belly, mate.
Oh, about being short. No. I'm not being short.
No, we can see your penis.
I like
it.
Oh, we know.
I mean, are you staying when you bring the lead back?
Yeah.
You can go on this commentary with John.
I think so.
It's for the big one. For the big one.
Big one.
Well, you've got the big one.
I'd start a comment on your missus. You're definitely punching. She's a really good looking lady, isn't she?
Yeah,
Yeah, massively.
She dances as well, so she's super flexible.
Yeah, yeah. I remember you telling me.
She's a lovely girl.
We've both done well, really, haven't we? Because I'm a fucking fat Toby and you're a wee man. I mean, how have we managed that? I've got a personal trainer and you've got some flexible dance light instructor or whatever. I don't know what you must be hung like a horse. At least it makes one of us. He doesn't even have to duck to go past the camera. That's embarrassing.
He must be pretty hung, mustn't he?
I don't know. I mean, I used to say to people all the time, because my mates used to mug blokes and go, how the fuck have they got that bird?
I know,
he's a nice guy and that's how he's got that bird. And I'm the same with my missus. I'm a top bloke. I just like... Nah, I'm not even hung either. That's the worst thing about it. Right. So fuck knows why she's with me, because I'm skint as fuck at the moment as well.
Skint as fuck. But you're a nice guy, though. Makes up for it, though, doesn't it?
Well, yeah, I'm a bit of a cunt as well, but I suppose.
Okay.
I've been told. I'm just going on what I've been told. By your Joe? Missus. No. Well, does this pass? Must pass, I'll take it. He'd just be playing this into the top pocket and leaving the angle.
Played it well.
Yeah, it's a good shot, to be fair. It's a good shot. This looks like going 5-4. This match is going to and fro.
We did say 8-6, 8-6, 8-7, didn't we?
At the start of the commentary, we both said this could go 7-all.
Yeah.
I mean, we had our predictions, but the main prediction and the money would have been on 7-all, especially as they both started so badly. Oh. Wow.
As you go for the cocked hat here, yeah?
Cocked hat, you toad. Andy's had one too many Coca-Colas.
Yes. I'm going to be passing you back to Joe in a minute.
This is a bit too twitchy, though.
For the final, for the climax of this match.
He's already twitched on one similar to this, yeah.
Is it? What's he doing here, then? He's not too happy
about this, I think. I think when he watches it back...
It was a bit over the top, wasn't it?
I mean, I think I've done the same sort of thing. I was up and about.
Anyway, I'm going to hand this to Joe. Here he is. It's Joe.
He's jumping out the shot, isn't it? No. You're giving us so much stuff to comment on.
What have I missed?
Well, I think... And we have... Andy Tonkis in the gaff.
Dr. Robotnik has turned up.
Dr. Robotnik. What else can we call him? The Pikey. We call him the Pikey. Andy, how did you get on in your match last night against my friend Anthony Hill?
I scraped it
9-3. 9-3? Wow, wait until I see him.
Is that Anthony Hill that used to work in
Sainsbury's? It might be, yeah.
Yeah,
well,
he used to be a chef.
He used to be a real good ball player, man.
He's a good umpire.
Yeah. I used to play football all the time.
He used to tip me my lunch at work.
Yeah, he's good. He's a good lad. He is.
Until payday, and I used to have like a month bill.
He's a good lad. He is.
Yeah. He mentioned you before when he used to work. Yeah, same guy. Here is the paedophile cookie. Yep.
Cookie the fossil's in. He's 5-4 down. Yeah, to be honest, they've both had chances. I mean, it could be like 8-0. Both ways, because they've both not taken their chances. But the main, most important thing is Chris has got a smile on his face.
It's because he knows what he's going home
now,
to.
Just in case you're not going to watch this match back, we're just going to give you a recap over what happened a minute ago. Not that we want to put Jimmy off or anything, but there was a situation a minute ago. In the, not the last frame, but the frame before that, where there was a yellow and the black on the table. Chris has rattled the black into the top pocket, and James, not remembering that he's got a yellow on the table, has got down and potted the black.
Fair enough.
Which, obviously, he lost the frame. I'll give you that. It was a good pot on the black. I will say it was a good pot on the black, to be fair. Wow, if that didn't go, that was a foul. But yeah, so it's worth watching this match back just to see that, because it is very funny.
That's a good shot. That's a good stitch. wants to try and hit the red by the yellow, really.
To be honest, I think I'm trying to... I can't quite see from his angle if that red goes into the opposite pocket. I take it doesn't. Otherwise, I'd be going for the pot here myself. Full-blooded, I'd be going.
I think... I think I'd have been trying to hit that red by the yellow.
Yeah.
Now, with two, I'd be playing this yellow down the cushion, potting the red, and then playing safe again.
Taking control of the table.
Yeah, take control of the table. Now the two yellows where he stitched from them behind.
Yep.
Two yellows where he stitched ones from before, yeah.
More or less the same shot, yeah, off the glance off behind, yeah, it.
Even if he leaves in the red, it's like there's no pot on.
Yeah, I mean, to be fair. Here he comes.
Yeah,
here he comes. Rat Fink is in the building.
That's not the worst. Gets his balls out.
Well, that is a little bit unlucky.
If the red comes out a bit more. Roll up to this yellow. Oh no, wow. He's gone.
Well, I don't know, gone full blooded again. I'm not quite sure what he was doing there, though. To be fair,
I think he was trying to pot it and move the two yellows by the red.
Don't see much value in that.
No.
Oh, he's put it on the cushion, has he? No, he has stopped. I mean, Jimmy here, if he can just glance off this, he can almost snooker him with his own ball.
Yeah. Oh, Craig Shields on the phone to his drug dealer.
Yeah. And the pie key's back in the room. How can Andy beat anybody 9-3 or 8-3 or whatever it was in...
I don't know.
Right.
But
I'm not joking.
The worst thing is,
Ant,
he's in Division 2.
Ant used to be brilliant.
Really?
Yeah, he used to be a real good ball player. I'm not, I mean, maybe not quite the same as me and you, but I mean, he's more than capable of running two or three dishes off in a row. So, I mean, yeah, no, I mean, I'd say he can play just as good as me, really. So,
you're a bit surprised by the result.
Kieran, his dish to go
7-6
up. Wow, that match has toed and froed all the way there.
All these sort of matches are close.
Apart from Cole Stratton.
Yeah, I mean, that is it. That's kind of like Everton versus West Brom, and West Brom have a day off. But all of these are basically Southampton versus Bournemouth. That's a good shot. Pretty much anything could occur. It's hard to call these matches either way, really, which is how it should be. And it's good for competition play. Oh, it's good for competition play, and it makes for good viewing, obviously. Because it doesn't have to be top notch.
No.
For it to be a good
match
to watch.
There's plenty of drama in. It's nice to see people missing every now and then. It adds to the old drama, doesn't it?
Yeah, I mean, who wants people to sit there making 1-2-4 breaks?
Yeah.
It's just stupid, isn't it?
Bollocks, isn't it, really? Boring.
Well, for me, Chris has got to take this out now. I think it just about sneaks in. I can't quite see it. But he might be trying to move it here himself anyway.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure he can pinch enough of that pocket, but he's hit that a bit hard.
Well, he's just rolling off this to the side cushion,
yeah,
isn't he?
Yeah, got to be. The thing is, he's
even Sean Mason knows a shot from here.
But he's leaving the up and down. And all he's got to do is hit it and he takes the bag.
Well, is there a case then of playing the yellow onto the side cushion and off and almost playing, so leaving a touching ball almost? He's taken the up and down out of the equation, but obviously this is an easy hit.
Mm. Could leave him in the spot of bother.
Oh, there's a little bit of a grimace by Sean there. He's not too sure about this.
See that, mate.
Well, I think the goes.
He's going for this.
I don't think he is.
I think he is. I'm telling you, I know Chris too well. So aggressive.
I mean, that's...
It's not, I know it's a bit of a shot to nothing.
Yeah, yeah. I think the yellow might have blocked the up and down, is it? I'm not sure. I can't really see from him.
Yeah. I say yes.
Joe says yes. Sean says no. Mm. Well, we're about to find out who's the idiot.
It's definitely me. Definitely me.
Yeah, yeah. It's good here. There's a lot of pressure on this now, though. Chris has basically got to take this out from here. This looks like this could be going 6-5.
6-4. 6-4. I'm not saying anything with the way this match has been going.
No.
That's a good pot from
that
Chris.
That is a great pot. He's given himself every chance of winning the frame from here. He's just got to hold himself together.
That's another good. He's gone enough.
That is very unlucky. Good pot, Vim. Well, the true to form, most of these matches, shall we say, against the lesser players, they're going to be quite evenly matched. Mm. Showing, like, not no disrespect to anybody, obviously.
Like you.
No. All right, they're both guns. It's 7-7 in that match, so that's going to a decider. And
has Kieran changed colour over there or what?
Change colour? Yeah.
It's colour of the balls.
He's turned to a lobster, isn't he?
Just put one down every shoe.
I'd just like to congratulate Carl on his win. Well, 6-4.
To be fair, the pair of them have missed easier though, the whole way through this.
Look, he don't like it. He does not like it.
Well, that looks short. That looks short.
Yeah.
I told you the way this match is going.
The frame's gone like this.
Pretty much.
Every frame I've seen.
And that is 5-5.
Yeah, well, I mean.
That's what I said to you.
Yeah. It's true. It's true to form of how this match has gone.
That Foster's tastes nice, doesn't it?
Oh, mate. Fucking brand new, mate.
He was
the payee. Well, he was the payer. I was the.
I treated my hoe.
Well, a taxi driver. Treated his fucking taxi driver. Needs to move, mate. He does. Lives in the right shit place to get to. Yep. Yep, two gifts.
Was it a sweaty Donald?
Yeah.
Oh, was it? Big sweaty.
Yeah, mate. You missed out, innit?
I wouldn't mind, but we was playing snooker and it was like 5 o'clock and we was like, I'm hungry. Big sweaty
dollar
at 5 o'clock.
I was clucking, mate. My belly was going, ow.
Was that with no beer in you?
Yeah. Oh, you don't need beer to have fucking shit food. Look at the state of me.
At 5-5, if someone can take out one visit dish,
yes,
they can run away with it then.
If anybody gets a 2-frame advantage, it's massive. Obviously, there'd be 2 up with 3 to play.
Is he going to play this and move the other red?
Oh, wow.
Well, he tried
to miss that cannon is bad. That is bad. He should be getting it. Should be. He's a good enough player to be able to play a cannon like that. Yeah. I mean, it wasn't even a hard cannon, really.
Well, My bottom's sore.
Have you had a shit?
Yeah, I had a big one.
Yeah.
Big, big one.
Just like to say, quick shout out to Dave. She's doing her hair.
It's because she keeps getting fucked.
Is she getting done?
Yeah, she must be. You was the one that told me about it.
Yeah, I know, yeah, but obviously you are at her premises and place of sleeping, or residence, shall I say, more than me.
Would you?
Pissed I mean, enough? She's a nice girl and all yeah. that, but I mean, to be fair, I've done, when I was about 19, I was in bar 26, which is, if someone's watching from a long way away, which probably they're not, so I'm just going to go with everybody knows what bar 26 is.
I don't.
When I was about 19.
That's where I'll go see from,
right? Yeah, yeah. When I was about 19, my mate, Spicer, he literally used to do 20, 25 stone plus birds. He didn't give a shit. We used to call it big game hunting. Now, I was in bar 26 snogging this bird, which I could only describe as looking like a skunk. She had black and white hair. She was about 55. I was about 19. And even he was trying to pull me off of her. And I'm kissing her, going, nah, it'll be all right. And I took her back to Athelstan Road, which is where she lived. And I'd done her. And I'd done her up the arse after. And I fucking ran out of her house. And that is on my auntie's grave. And that is probably the worst bird you'll ever see in your life as well. But I've lived to tell the tale, so who's laughing now? But yeah, you ask him. He will say it is the worst bird he's ever seen. And he has seen some fucking shunts. Yeah, no, I am. I don't give a shit. Oh, I didn't die.
And you're doing all right for yourself now?
Yeah, to be honest, I am doing more than all right. Maybe it's God's way of making up for all the shitters that I've done. He's planted me in with a fucking winner. It's about time he fucking delivered on something.
Don't deliver on a Saturday, does he?
No, I've been waiting my whole life for another 2 inches. Cunt's never turned up.
So what were you talking about before that conversation anyway? Before you said about doing that over bar 26?
Oh, Vicky. Dave.
Rodney, as we call her.
I'll show you.
She looks like Rodney.
I'll show you.
Fools and Horses.
Obviously you know who Rodney is. Everybody calls her Dave. Well, me, Matt Hughes, Ian, Tom, Carl.
I think Matt Hughes was the one that started it.
Yeah, I think he was.
Walk in and go, can I have a pint, please, Dave?
I made a meme up. Let's have a little look. I have to go back quite a way because it was fucking right at the beginning. Look, 2,270 images, Marv.
That group chat's brutal that we
got,
mate.
Hey.
It's because when she had short hair.
Yeah, I'm going to find the meme.
No, yeah.
It's going to be fucking way back, man. No, this is in our chat group.
Chat group. That's not every photo he's got in his phone. That's just our chat group.
Yeah, I've got fucking tons.
I think you're looking at about November time. That was Tom's leaving, dude, 2 years ago.
September. November
2015, wasn't it?
Right, let's go back from there. Do you want to commentate on the match while I'm doing this?
I forgot all about the pool.
Where is it, mate?
That's a very good shot from James taking the pocket.
Fucking hell, it's really pissing me off. Where is it?
And here is the pest.
Dyer. Kieran.
It could have been
8 years. Oh, mate,
where is it? As long as I break, well, I'll be alright.
Okay, but you're in trouble then.
Yeah.
Oh, mate, where is it?
He's not often my break lights. Let's be serious.
Oh, there it is, look. My name's not Rodney, it's Dave. my name's Rodney, not Dave. Aye, here he is. The main man's in the building.
Oh, here it is. ISIS.
Whoopsie. Fucking, what we got here?
Craig brought them down to work.
Good lad. Cakes,
lemon drizzle or raspberry or jam or something.
Oh, is that lemon drizzle? Didn't we have that? Raspberry and jam.
I don't want that. I want that.
Oh, should we be eating this?
Well done, Ratty. Thank
you. Lemon drizzle like. Left. Sure.
Sorry, we've kind of been distracted by cake.
I said thank you, Ratty. Of course. Victory for Vineyard. Another victory for the Vineyard.
No, his first victory.
Is it? Yeah. Oh yeah, you lost the game to your pal, didn't you? Hey, scrape a victory every now and then. Here he comes, the loser.
Like Sunderland against Swansea.
Relegation badge. What am I looking at? Ah, wow, 6-5. And Jimmy's doing his best teapot impression. It's just off camera, you probably can't see it actually. It's lucky we know he's got a bird. Or do we? No. Thank you. Yeah, we noticed that, mate, the other day on the camera. You'll hear us talking about it. Well, they say the camera adds £10. You must have had at least four cameras on you. What's the crack in this, anyway? I've been away.
I don't know. I was eating cake.
Yeah, me too. 6-5 still.
I've already done it.
Yeah, I've done it.
It's the way we've been doing it every week.
Yeah, isn't
it?
No, we didn't even get that out last week.
Oh, I couldn't find it, that's why.
Oh, right, okay.
We did get the scoreboard out.
No, we didn't get the little bit.
The number board.
Oh, the number board, all right. Oh, yeah.
Are we going to brush the tables before the next round of matches?
Yeah.
Okay, mate, yeah, I've got the. There's only two to brush.
No, I know.
Deal with that.
Bad time you done summit. Bad time you done summit. Stop trying to get away from your missus.
Yeah. They were on point, to be fair. That was all right. Yeah, not bad for a free one. Don't know if I'd pay for it. Yeah. Oh yeah, he loves it. Bit of dribble.
This looks like.
Whoa. Oh, he'll settle for that. He'll settle for that. Shaking his head. He's got lucky though there, really.
Has he missed it? Oh, he has missed it.
I got, second best burger nearly the first. Oh, my fucking God. I mean, it was ridiculous. I sniffed it out.
Just tell him to go and die, right? Nobody cares about him and his views. Just tell him to fuck off.
Well.
Smelly breath. Prick. Pretty much, yeah.
Well, Jimmy has missed three blacks.
Yeah.
This match could have been very different. Mm. And obviously he potted that black.
Mm. Can be a really good player. But this game is very topsy-turvy.
Well, I think, I'm not sure if Chris has got the angle. He might have to go in and out of bulk here.
Could he not just roll it in and leave a shot?
I'm not sure. I'm not quite sure what angle he's got from here, but it. The way he's gearing up, he's looked at the top cushion. Even to leave it half ball though, yeah. I mean, I think just dropping it in is a way forward.
Yeah, I think. That's just leave a shot.
Yeah, I think it was almost a little bit of Hollywood in there. But we've seen easier missed.
This is true.
Oh,
have you noticed every time there's a pressure pot, the jukebox, wing. The music stops. It makes it even worse. And that is 7-5.
Well, that
Chris.
Is 7-5. Who broke first? Fucking.
Missed three blacks, didn't you?
Oh, mate.
Nah, it's just one of those days, isn't it? Yeah, Chris has dragged him into the trenches.
Oh, Sal and Sean Mason are about to get it on.
Yeah, I wouldn't
the
have minded.
Match.
I wouldn't have minded watching that myself, but be commentating on the following match
with
yourself
on
it. Someone, both players needed to play early. One of them, I think, Chris needed to play early.
You could have put him on one. Just had Mason and Sal seven.
Yeah, but then there was another one that needed to. I don't know why I didn't. It was just.
You've had a shocker then.
Yeah, I've had a mare. Well, how do you feel then, Vin? You're up and running with your first victory?
Over the moon, Jim. Over the moon.
Yeah? Happy days?
Sorry, John.
Jim, yeah. He's playing, mate. He's playing. So, does that take you off the bottom?
JCB would probably take me off the bottom, mate.
I don't know. Could be the Undertaker still. Could be Dan in the depths. Well, look, Jimmy's on stilts here. He had to grow a couple of inches to get to that ball.
It's still not over, though, if he manages to take this out. And the fact that he looks like he's going to lose this match might actually take the pressure off a little bit.
Yeah, it's just he seems to be quickening up.
Vin, did you, like, honestly, when you was playing and you knew it was on camera, do you feel it a little bit when it's on?
To be honest with you, mate, I thought you was checking my arse out. That's what I was worried about.
Well, I do that when we play poker, mate. During the break.
Really?
Spent 15 minutes of my life, mate.
Observing me bent over a poker table.
Oh, yeah.
Playing with my chips.
Playing with something. Big pop.
Split three-way Sunday night with Danny and Phil, you know, Chinese
yeah, yeah.
Phil.
Yeah, yeah. I played the...
Big.
Yeah.
Any good?
39.
No, out
of Busto.
Many?
500.
Yeah, sorry.
Home, 22 grand to the winner.
Yeah. Was you top?
We know.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
Where did Phil anywhere? Oh, no, he came. He was on there Sunday night.
Yeah. The only people that played it was me, James, Jimmy Bullock. James. Yeah. Jamie Bullock. And.
Oh, dear. Oh, dear. What is she doing here?
Look, she's going for a shit. Cheers.
He's played a bit of stinker there.
Yeah, I'm not sure he hasn't left that. Me, James, and Martin Holmes. But we went up separately. I know Cranefly played it on the Thursday. Didn't get through. Couldn't play another day. But yeah, I got through. Real amateurish shove on a queen I board with ace queen. Got slow rolled. Bad slow roll as well. Yeah. The blinds are. 6 and 12k. I've got 300k. Someone's raised it to 26k. There's another call that I've made it 100k with ace queen. The bloke has dwelled up, then called. The flop's come queen 7 9, all diamonds. I've got no diamonds, but I've got to protect my hand at that stage. If someone flopped the, do you know what odds they are to flop a flush? 80 to 1. You are 80 to 1 to flop a flush. So if they flopped a flush, good luck to them. So I ship for my 200k. I can pretty much double through there and then. He tanked for 2.5 minutes. What do you reckon he had?
Queen 7 9 all diamonds.
What do you reckon he had? Bearing in mind he's got 700, probably about 700k behind. So they calls nothing to him. Exactly the hand he had. Jack 10 of diamonds. He flopped a flush and he wants to tank when he's got an up and down straight flush draw. He tanked for 2.5 minutes. He turned the cards over. Everybody went berserk. I was like, prick. Just walked off. It came a 7 on the turn. I was like, if there's any justice, I'm fucking spiking here. Obviously, I went out. Wow, quick shit. Just like to say that obviously Ness never bothers washing her hands. All right.
Well, that's unlucky. No.
Good luck. If he hits this will be the shot. Oh, that was unlucky. That'd have been the shot of all times. That would. That a fuck.
It did go. We checked it.
That'd have been an unbelievable shot if he'd have got that. Jimmy Hoare.
Chris McManus for the victory. I said 8-6, Chris, at the start of this.
But it's 8-5.
Yeah, but I mean, if he takes this.
Yeah.
Honey, mate.
Yeah.
Okay. Fuck knows where he's gone. We reckon he's gone to a titty bar in Euston Road.
He did tell me where he's gone, I can't think, but yeah, he got married.
Fucking somehow you are.
Yeah.
Somehow he is. He didn't even have a stag
door
or fucking anything else, did he?
So, yeah. Oh, whoa, that needs to hold up. He's got to hold his nerve here for an 8-5 victory.
He's keeping it quiet until after he's on the DL.
Yeah, keep it on the DL.
Yeah, yeah. That's and Matt is
that's
plum.
A good positional shot.
Well, it hasn't been pretty, but it's over. James is already rolling his joint for outside. The camera's there, mate, if you want to apologise. Still not on camera. What a silly cunt. Well, I'd just like to point out that they have been watching you for the last hour on the table. The chances are they've seen your face. Nah.
Oh, well, I'll be sharing it to every group possible.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I might even send it to Beard Productions, see if they want to put it on their pool. On their pool. And the pool stream. That's true. No one looks at how many games Leicester won 1-0 and they scrape through. They won the trophy and that's all they look at. Well, okay. Well, I was trying to pick you up, mate. Sorry. Anyway, we'll leave it there.